Hey there, it's Vicky Marie. I want to welcome you back to my channel today. We're going to do a Tiny Tidy today. This is the Tiny Tidy collab hosted by Sunday Dawn over at The Helpful Home. I got through with a 5-day major vertigo episode where it was just bad. It was bad. It occurred, and I'm going to just chat with you a little bit about that, and I'll show you a couple, I'll show you something fun John got for Father's Day. So happy Father's Day to all you fathers out there, and you people, you guys who father others. I mean, even if you're not a biological father, I know there have been a lot of father figures in my own life that I've looked up to and have helped me and over the years. So I always am mindful of that too. So, but yeah, it was just Father's Day, and John, my daughter got John this Wineopoly game. And I think that's pretty cool. So it's like Monopoly, only Wineopoly. I don't like playing Monopoly with my husband because he always wins and I get frustrated. Ugh. So, and he'll probably win at Wineopoly as well because I really don't know a whole lot about wine. I drink it occasionally, not as much as I used to. Like, I don't really drink that much at all anymore. But I thought I would share that with you because that was pretty cool. Something I really hadn't seen out in the world. And then I did finish reading Where the Crawdads Sing. And I finished reading Under the Whispering Door. And I always link these in my description. I show you guys what I'm reading. Just, I don't know. I always am curious what other people are reading. And I am reading more these days because sometimes I get these vertigo episodes and I just have to go with the flow. And it forces me to slow down and be more mindful, which I'm always saying that anyway. I want to live a more intentional and mindful life. And now I have no choice. So if you want to make God laugh, tell me your plan. This isn't how I would have chosen to do it, but I'm using this as a catapult, you know, sort of, you might as well, like, you know, there's certain things we just don't have control over, right? So, and it could be worse. It's just a little vertigo, but man, it really does affect me. And the other day I was in the gym feeling really strong in my home gym because I still haven't gone out to Planet Fitness. Yet I'm not feeling quite confident. So I was in my home gym and I was doing some push-ups on the Bosee ball. Like, I'm feeling good. I haven't had any major vertigo in a few weeks. So I'm like, wow, I'm really doing well. Finished the physical therapy and everything. And if you guys, I do have a video out that it talks a little more about the BPPV that I've been dealing with, and I won't go into that now. But, you know, vertigo is very common. It's a positional vertigo. It's the most common form of vertigo. It's a benign, very benign. It's not anything serious other than the risk of fall when you get it. So you have to kind of watch your step. It hit me really hard. I was in the gym doing some Bosee ball push-ups. And the last time I had an episode was when I did hamstring curls. So it's when I lay on my stomach in that position and put my head down, that seems to be a huge trigger for me. So I'm learning not to do that. I can't bend down, like to bend down to tie your shoes. I can't do that anymore. And so, like, I'm using Swifters and things like that to dust and things like that. So as long as I keep my head forward, I feel good. So I'm dealing with it. I'm still doing physical therapy exercises and things like that to help me with the balance. And I'm optimistic that this will go away. It's like not something, I mean, like there are a lot of different, like there's a lot of information out there about vertigo, but a lot of people have said, and you guys have shared that you have it or you had it and you went through this and then it sort of went away after a few weeks or a few months. It just went away on its own. And that very well could happen. I'm hoping that that's what happens to me. They say that does happen, and I think I read somewhere it was like 50% of the cases that will happen because those crystals just they dislodge, and you know that's what causes the imbalance in your inner ear, and then they end up getting stuck somewhere else where they're not a problem. So let's hope that happens. But you know, I'm just sharing what I'm learning. I'm no expert. I'll just share with you my own experience. So if you have vertigo or you've had vertigo, share in the comments. Let's learn from each other because I'm trying to figure it out. But I'm learning what triggers me and what I can do and what I can't do. And there are certain things in the gym I probably won't do anymore. And I'm really sad. I mean, like, I realized how much of my identity was kind of wrapped up in this being strong and resourceful. And, you know, and I don't like to ask for help. You know, I do not like to ask for help. And I do not like I just feel like I don't know. I'm sure I'm not the only one, but it's really, really hard for me to ask for help or to look vulnerable. So, and that's not proud of that because it's something I'm working on. So, anyway, I know that, you know, we're all dealing with different things. And, you know, I'm 57 years old. I'm learning, you know, like my body's not going to last forever, right? I mean, that's just a fact of life. We don't last forever in this physical existence. Some of us, myself included, believe that, you know, there's something after this. I think a lot of us believe that. And I take solace in that. And I try to work on my character and my soul, you know, what's going to carry forward. But I do have to kind of learn how to, you know, how to maneuver and navigate in my life every time something changes. And I know you guys, a lot of you can relate to that. So I do want to say I was listening to, Diane over at, Diana at Diana Simplifies was talking about these vertigo bracelets. She had commented. I had talked about my vertigo, and she was telling me about these vertigo bracelets. They work with because of acupressure. They create a point right here on this point on your wrist that's supposed to help with the nausea created by vertigo and motion sickness. A lot of people use these when they go out on the boat if they get motion sickness. So you wear one on each wrist. I bought some from Amazon. I bought 11 of them. They're in a box somewhere in my house. I lost them. So I went back to Walgreens and I bought these. These were like $14. They're the Walgreens brand. And I've been wearing these for a couple of days after this really bad episode that I've had. And I can say, I don't know if they're helping. I really don't know, but I'm willing to try it. And I have not really had any major nausea while wearing them. And I know a few days ago, the nausea was so bad, I thought I was going to get sick twice, and I did not, but I'm just being transparent. That's how it is. You just get really, really sick. Like the room visually spins, you get sick. And it's like, you know. So anyway, Diana, if you're watching, I don't know. I think that they might be helping, but I told you I'd keep you posted. So if anybody else has BPPV or vertigo, and you get nauseous, let me know if you've tried these. I also bought some ginger gum and I chew on that sometimes, and that seems to help. So, but I've been very dizzy for about 5 days, just on and off, after the initial episode didn't last long, but it made me sick. And then for about 4 days after that, I'm just feeling woozy. So I'm going slow and I'm doing videos as I can. Also, I wanted to share, because I finished reading the book, Where the Crawdads Sing, and the book, Under the Whispering Door. I liked them both. And I watched the movie, Where the Crawdads Sing, and I liked that too. John watched it with me. We both enjoyed it. I got those books, I gave to my daughter, and now she's going to read those books. So, and Frances, if you watch this, she said, yes, you had recommended that book to her. So she is now, she's got the book and she's going to read it. So just a shout out to my beautiful aunt. So Jamie gave me these books. These are the Ender's Game series. And these were one of her friends who is no longer here with us. It was his favorite book. And so she wanted to read it. And she read these, and she said they're really good. And if you saw the movie, The Ender's Game, she says it's nothing like the book. Nothing like the book. They don't even hardly cover anything in here. She says, you got to read the book. So she gave me 4 books to read. So that's going to keep me busy for a while. I'm just going to start with the first one, see how it goes. And if I get hooked, I will read them. Also, I'm currently reading. I don't even know if I should share some of these things that I read because my taste is not going to be like yours. But you know, we're all different. So here you go. I am just sharing my eclectic interest with you. I am reading The Day After Roswell. And it was written by a colonel, retired colonel, and I've always been fascinated. My dad was fascinated with the story. He was 20 years military, and we've always been very fascinated with that kind of stuff. So I am reading The Day After Roswell, and let me tell you, I'm on chapter 4, and I'm talking to John about it because John's a history buff. He's very, very much a history buff, and we're talking about certain things and looking at timelines and going, wow, I never heard this, never heard that. Of course, you've got to make up your own mind about these things because who knows? Like, we don't know. I don't know. I wasn't there. I can only hear what other people share about it. And our memories don't always serve us over time. We might remember things differently. But this book was written a while back, and it's very interesting. So I am reading it. I'm really enjoying it. So that's what I'm reading now, y'all. So and what you see is what you get here on my channel, because it's all I can do to just keep you caught up with my topsy-turvy life, like literally my topsy-turvy life. All right. But we're all good. I'm in good spirits and we're all healthy, relatively healthy, and, you know, can't complain. Life is good. And I've got way more blessings than I have anything to complain about. Well, that's going to be it today. I hope that you're doing well and whatever you're dealing with, because we're all dealing with stuff. You know, we got to make the most of it. And, you know, you're not alone. And I just think it helps sometimes to just jump on and share the real stuff. So, all right. I hope you're doing well. Let me know if you guys have read any of these books, or if you read The Day After Roswell, or any of the books I've mentioned. I try to link them in my description. Okay, that's it. Hope you're doing well. Take care. I'll see you on the next one. I know you're all about the good vibes. Do you know how much I love you? Want to see you smile. Where's that happy girl that